Students, in today's class we are going to see the protocol RS-232, its pin configuration, introduction to RS-232, and how you are going to interface RS-232 with 8051 and 8051 introduction with RS-232. So all these topics we are going to see in this class. So this is the function pin configuration of RS-232 connector. This image has been scanned from the book called Masdi of microcontroller book. Before getting into in depth about this pin configuration, first I wanted to say what is meant by RS-232. So RS-232 means it is the recommended standard. R stands for recommended, S stands for standard. So RS means it is your recommended standard 232. So this is a standard protocol. So in the previous class we have seen what is meant by your the SPI, that is serial peripheral interface, and the second one what we have seen is I square C, that is inter integrated circuit, and also you have the protocol to communicate with the other device called USB, and one more protocol, Ethernet. So apart from all these things, this RS-232 is the common protocol or the common one which we are going to use it for serial communication. So it is mostly used for connecting your computer to the peripheral device, because in a computer we will be writing a program, and suppose if I wanted to interface my hardware with the software, so I have written a program in the software, that is in computer the program will be available. If I want my hardware to get operated based on the instruction given by this software, I'll be connecting the computer with the peripheral device. This peripheral device is nothing but a hardware device, and it is connected through RS-232. RS-232 is nothing but recommended standard 232. It is a standard protocol for your serial communication, and also it is used for connecting your computer with a peripheral device. So it just allows the data exchange between them. Whatever data you have it in the software, that will be loaded onto the peripheral device. Based on the operation, some amount of data will also be loaded just for checking the condition in the software. So this RS-232, it just allows your peripheral device to exchange the data between your computer and the other hardware devices. So what is the why we are considering this RS-232 as a common protocol? In the sense, it is used for long distance communication, that is up to 50 feet you can have a communication with a rated speed of 1.492 kbps, that is kilobits per second. Why it is the most common preferable protocol? In the sense, you can transmit or you can exchange the data between your peripheral device and the computer till to a distance of 50 feet, and also it is used to and it transfers the data at the rate of 1.492 kilobits per second. So only it is called as it is the most common protocol that we are going to prefer in a microcontroller. And all moreover, this RS-232 is mainly used for connecting your DTE, that is data transmission equipment, and the next one is DCE. So it allows these two features. This RS-232 is used for connecting data transmission equipment and data communication equipment. This is the basic introduction about RS-232. So I'll summarize the point one more time. What RS-232 is? RS-232. RS stands for it is your recommended standard protocol. RS is your recommended standard 232. It is a protocol. The importance of this one is it is a very common protocol, that is it is a standard protocol for your serial communication. It is your standard protocol for your serial communication, and also it is used for connecting your computer with your peripheral device. So in a computer we will be writing a program, and this peripheral device could be of any hardware device. So when you wanted to have the peripheral device to work based on the program written. You will be connecting the computer with the peripheral device through a protocol called RS-232. So it is a standard protocol, and also this protocol is most preferably preferred. Why? Because it is mainly used for connecting your DTE, that is data transmission equipment, and the second one is your data communication equipment. So these are all the important points, that is introduction of your RS-232. So before you connect RS-232 to 8051, you should understand the pin configuration of RS-232. Then only you can connect the correct pin with the correct port of your 8051 microcontroller. So as we discussed, we will be reading the pin configuration, pin details of your RS-232. We have shown the pin configuration of RS-232 over here. So it is your 9-pin port as shown here. The first pin will be on your left top corner, first pin, second pin, third pin, fourth pin, fifth pin, and below 6, 7, 8, 9. So each pin serves some purpose. RS-232 is very, very important just because it will be connecting your DTE, that is data transmission equipment and data communication equipment. These two equipments are responsible for transmitting the data from your computer to terminal. These two things is computer to terminal or from terminal to computer. So it is very, very important to transmit or receive the data either from your computer to the terminal or from the terminal to the computer. So we'll see the pin description of RS-232. So the pin description, the first pin stands for data carrier detector. What is meant by a data carrier detector? For example, you will be sending a data from your transmitting end to your receiving end. You consider you are going to send the data from your transmitting end to the receiving end. This data carrier detect, DCD, it is one of your important signal. It is just like your modem assert signal. This DCD is nothing but, it is just like your modem assert signal. It is just like your modem assert signal that to inform the DTE, that is data transmission equipment. It will inform this data transmission equipment that a valid data carrier is detected, that is a valid data is detected to transmit the data from your transmitting end to your receiving end. That is, it just establishes a connect or contact between the transmitting end and the receiving end, or from one end to the other modem, which is going to be established. So the first point is your, the first pin of your RS-232 is data carrier detect. Data carrier detect, it is an important signal. It is called as your modem assert signal. Modem assert signal. This signal is important to, that is this signal, what it does in the sense, it sends a information, it sends an information or it sends a signal to DTE, that is data transmission equipment. It sends a information or signal to the DTE stating that a valid data carrier is available to transmit. So for this purpose you are going to use this data carrier detector. Next is your RXD. So once the data carrier detect is identified, next is your RXD. It is just for receiving your data. RXD stands for receive data. TXD stands for transmit data, which we know already. The next one is your DTR, that is data terminal ready. DTR stands for data terminal ready. So DTR stands for data terminal ready. What it does in the sense, once your DCD, that is DCD is nothing but data carrier detect, it will send a signal to DTE stating that a valid data information is available on your transmitting channel. Once this DTE receives the signal, the data terminal ready, when it turns on, it sends out a signal to indicate that it is ready for communication. Once it receives, once after this data transmission equipment receives the signal from data carrier deduct, it informs your data terminal ready to be, it sends the signal to data terminal ready. Then this data terminal ready will send an output signal where it specifies that it is ready for transmitting your data, that it is ready for communicating the data to the other device. Clear? So data carrier deduct will send a signal to DTE, that is data transmission equipment, stating that a valid data is available on the communication channel. Then after identifying a valid data carrier is available in the communication channel, this DTE will request to DTR, that is data terminal ready, to be ready for the communication. So after it receives a signal from DTE, the data terminal ready will be enabled, stating that it is ready to communicate the data from your transmitting end to your receiving end. So this is the importance of your DTE, that is data terminal equipment and data terminal ready. It is the difference. Next is your signal ground. Signal ground is mainly meant to avoid the noise. Suppose when you are transmitting the signal from your transmitting end to the receiving end, it is not that only one data carrier to be flown through the channel. So it means that due to hissing, like due to the disturbance in the frequency, there will be a hissing noise available between your sending end to the receiving end. Just to suppress all the unwanted noise signal and the hissing sound, we are going to connect to the signal ground. That is nothing but pin number 5. So pin number 1 is data carrier deduct, pin number 2 is receive data, pin number 3 is transmit data, pin number 4 is going to be data terminal ready, pin number 5 is signal ground. The next 6th pin is going to be DSR, data set ready. So data set ready in the sense, the RS-232 is going to connect your DTE and DCE. DTE is nothing but data terminal equipment and DCE is nothing but data communication equipment. So it is going to connect these two devices. So when this data communication equipment is turned on and has gone through the self-test, it assert a data set ready. It means that like when you are connecting, when you consider DCE is available, that is data communication equipment is available. When this data communication equipment is on, it means that it will undergo one self-test. It will only go for a self-test and it tells DSR, that is data set ready, to indicate that it is ready to communicate. So it will send a signal to this data set ready and inform that it is ready for communicating. So data set ready means it will be dealing it with your DCE, that is data communication equipment. So when your data communication, when RS-232 is connected to DTE and DCE, DTE will send a signal. For example, DCD, that is data carrier deduct. This data carrier deduct will send a signal to this DTE, that is data transmission equipment, stating that a valid data carrier is available in the channel. Then this DTE, as soon as it receives a signal from your data carrier deduct, this sends a signal to data terminal ready. So when it sends signal to data terminal ready, it is stating that you please be ready to transmit the available data on the channel. So once this data terminal ready, once it receives the signal from DTE, this data terminal ready output is going to be high, stating that it is ready for communication. Then as soon as this output goes high, it will receive a signal, that is this output high will be connected to your data communication equipment, because it has to communicate to the receiving end equipment, right? So it will be, this DCE will be receiving the signal from this data terminal ready, once DCE receives a signal, that is it when it goes on, when this DCE signal goes on, it is ready for doing your self-test. After doing your self-test, this DCE will send a signal. This DCE will send a signal to this data set ready, stating that you be ready to communicate. Once it is ready to communicate, it will send a request signal, that is RTS. When it is sending a RTS signal, when your DTE device has a byte to transmit, it receives a RTS signal, that is receive request to send the data from in through the transmitting channel. So when this signal is received, a byte of data will get transferred from your transmitting end to your receiving end. So this is how the process goes on in case of your RS-232. It is not that RS-232 means, you people might have seen, it is just like a wire. So any communication can happen through a group of wire, but each wire or each strand inside the cable is going to serve the purpose. So here all the 9 pins is going to serve the purpose, and the cycle of the communication is shown over here. Once the communication channel is over, once the data has been sent from your sending end to the receiving end, then your modem is ready. Like when after sending, you can clear all the signal using CTS, that is clear to send. Then ring indicator. So what is the purpose of your ring indicator? It is nothing but it is an output from the modem. Ring indicator is nothing but it is the output from the modem. Ring indicator is nothing but it is the output from the modem and input to the PC. Because this RS-232, between your computer and peripheral device you are going to connect, this ring indicator, it is the output from the modem and it is input to your PC. That indicates your telephone is ringing, it goes on and off and with a synchronous ringing sound. So these are all some of the functions of your RS-232 connector. Thank you students. In the next class, we will be dealing how to interconnect your RS-232 with 8051. Thank you.